Well, listen, hey everybody. Yeah, it's me. I'm back and I did not announce. I apologize. I did not announce that I would go on a little holiday hiatus, but that's what it's been. And so I'm back today just for a little minute, just for a minute. It's not a full show, but just to kind of check in and see how you're doing and just to chat about some of the top things that has happened in just the last few hours. Everyone's talking about this one, and that is, of course, the sad news about Damar Hamlin. He's the Buffalo Bills safety who is currently listed in critical condition, of course, after suffering cardiac arrest on the field during Monday night's last night's football game between the Bengals and the Buffalo Bills. Now, of course, the game was suspended in the first quarter when Damar Hamlin collapsed on the field after tackling Cincinnati wide receiver T. Higgins. Of course, medical emergency staff came onto the field and did some CPR and restored Hamlin's heartbeat before he was taken off the field by the ambulance. And during that whole process, his teammates, along with members of the Bengals team, formed a human wall around him to pray for him and protect him and cover him while he was receiving that treatment. And I was just floored. You know, I had the television on in the background, but I wasn't really watching the game. But when I saw, when I started paying attention, I was doing some other things. When I started paying attention, you know, I turned the volume up a little bit and I could hear the commentary and I could see them. All the players on the field sort of encircled around whatever was going on, but it was just an amazing act of humanity and grace and compassion and empathy. And man, I just it kind of brought me to tears. But anyway, it's now, as I stated, being reported that the 24-year-old football player is sedated and in critical condition at a hospital in Cincinnati. And it's also being reported that he apparently, Damar Hamlin, was doing a drive. He had been collecting money for a toy drive, and he wanted to hit a goal of about $2,500 before the start of Monday's game. And with some updated news, it's being reported now that as of Tuesday morning, this morning, the drive has raised over $3 million after an outpouring of support started coming through for him as a result of his medical situation. And so, you know, again, I just, you know, I'm just so grateful that they were able to revive him. And now he's, you know, somewhere safe where he's getting good medical treatment and he should recover. He's just 24 years old, but man, it was just something to see. All right, and I just wanted to kind of talk about that, but let's get the show started again. It's a brief show, so let's get it going, everybody. Oh yeah, it's the 2023 edition of Marilyn's Cafe Society right here on the YouTube channel. Welcome everybody. Welcome to the first show of 2023. Again, like I said, it's a short edition of the show. I'm just popping in. Today happens to be Tuesday, January the 3rd of the year 2023. And you know, people are still kind of officially holidaying, including me. That's right, to some degree at least, you know. But I just wanted to pop in. Like I said, it's been a while. You know what I mean? It's been a while. I just missed getting on the microphone and just kind of chit-chatting a bit. Now, as you know, I don't have any extended news stories or interviews or guests or cafe talk for that matter, but Before I go, I may just highlight another story or two like I did at the top of the show. But in the meantime, between time, I just want to know, how are you doing? How's your holiday break going? What are you doing? Did you travel? Did you stay home? What did you do? Yeah, inquiring minds want to know. So I want you to go ahead and chime in here in the comments section of the YouTube channel, or just hit me up on the various social media platforms and chime in there. I want to know what you did. As for me, you know, I've been on a hiatus, a holiday break from the show, but I have not been on a break from my other work, if you know what I mean. And so let me tell you, I have been one busy sister. That's right, very busy. So busy that all I could do on Christmas Day and even New Year's Day was just visit and rest. That's all, you know, you got to get that rest and hydration so that you can, you know, preserve yourself and all that good stuff. But anyway, it was all good. It's been all good. And so I'm going to be spending this week just kind of regrouping, you know, reflecting, getting things together in motion for this new year that we're in, 2023. Do we have a slogan? Do we have, you know how every year there's something that someone kind of puts out there and it catches on and everybody says, you know, I don't know, I'm just saying this, I'm gonna be free in 2023, you know, something like that. I haven't heard one yet, but maybe it'll pop up before we get too far in the year. All right, and so, you know, as I said, I really don't have much in terms of news, because it's just a pop in, just a hello, a check in. I was trying to think of some things that I was going to do for myself, you know, for the new year, because normally what I would do at the start of the new year is, you know, do something different with my hair, you know. And I just have just been so busy, I haven't even had an opportunity to seriously look at other things to do. And so I may just push that back to springtime and just come out in the spring with a new do. We'll see. How about you? What are you doing? What are you doing different to start out the new year? That's just something physically that I've been doing for the past few years. Other than that, I don't really do much, you know, other than, like I said, reflect and think about, you know, where I've been, how far I've come, and where I'd like to be, and all of that. And so, and it's all in my head. I have written some things down because, you know, everyone out there says it's best to write it down, because when you can see it every day, it just kind of reminds you to do something every day to get you a step closer to whatever goal or outcome you are aspiring to. And so that's where I am right now on this third day of January 2023. Now, before we go, I do want to just kind of highlight this. And I know you guys have probably heard the news. As a matter of fact, I know you have. But since we've last done a show, a broadcast here on the YouTube, there's been quite a bit of celebrity deaths. You know, some legendary, highly esteemed and regarded people have passed on, and going all the way back to, I think, the 14th of December was Stephen Twitch Boss. You know, the guy, the famed dancer, and then later became the DJ for Ellen DeGeneres on her TV talk show. He passed. Yeah, what, 40 years old. That came out of nowhere. And then, of course, we heard about the trailblazing news journalist, broadcaster, producer. We go on and on. Miss Barbara Walters, she, of course, has transitioned. Pope Benedict the 16th has transitioned. Anita Pointer of the award-winning Pointer Sisters, as well as a founding member of the Pointer Sisters, has transitioned. And then, of course, this one, I had to mention this one, and there are many others, but these are just some of the highlights, but this one. Oh my goodness. Yeah, you guys know me. Those who've been with me, you know Earth, Wind, and Fire is one of my most favorite bands of all times. And of course, the drummer, Freddie White, has passed on. And so, yeah, we send condolences and prayers and love and hugs and all of that to all those family members and friends of all those people and fans. And certainly pray that God is with you as you mourn and or celebrate their lives. All right, and of course I don't own rights to the music that I'm playing here. Don't own rights to it, but one of my favorite songs, Shining Star. And that's one of my favorite sayings. Everybody's a star. We all just have different ways of shining. And if we could just respect that about each other, I think the world would be a much better place, right? All right. And so another highlight that I wanted to mention is I've been seeing the backlash of this on social media and other places. It appears that the Rolling Stone 200 Greatest Singers list has upset some folks. Yeah, people are saying that they snubbed Celine Dion. They snubbed Jennifer Hudson, Tony Bennett, Justin Bieber, Nat King Cole. And of course, the list goes on and on and on. And again, like I said, music fans and industry folks are upset about it. But my question is this. So if they list everybody in one year, who's going to be left for the next year? You know what I mean? So and it is a list of 200 greatest singers. But so I'm not looking at it sort of like a snub. I'm just looking at it as, you know, it's just, if you want the list to live on, you just can't put everybody on the list in one year. They do this every year, right? But anyway, the good news about this list is that soul and R&B dominates their top 10. The list, the top 10, let me just start with number 10. The top 10 people on this list at number 10 is Al Green, Otis Redding, Beyonce. Number 7, Stevie Wonder. 6, Ray Charles, Mariah Carey, Billie Holiday. Coming in at number 3, Sam Cooke. Number 2, Whitney Houston. And number 1, Miss Aretha Franklin herself, the Queen of Soul. Yes. Now you want to know the top 20? All right, so let me go with the next set of 10, starting with number 20, Marvin Gaye, then Frank Sinatra, Celia Cruz, Elvis Presley, Prince, Bob Dylan, Freddie Mercury, Patsy Cline, John Lennon, Little Richard comes in at number 11. Isn't that something? Yeah. So, again, folks are upset because a lot of key names are missing from the list, but it's an annual list. And, you know, you got to save some for next year, is my opinion. But if you want that full list of 200, it's available on the Rolling Stones website. Okay, so you can check it out there now. The publication started this top 200 list back in 2008. And so they're going strong. What is this, 2020? So they're about 2023. So they're 14, 15 years strong with this list. And so I think people should just pipe down, right? Turn it down a little bit and just appreciate what they're doing. And, you know, just look for those names next year. I'm sure they will appear. All right, all right. Well, everybody, that's all I got, really. I just wanted to pop in. I do want to introduce the new word, and it's not a new word. Listen, repetition means everything. To repeat and revisit means everything. You know, it just helps you learn deeper. It sort of makes what you're learning, so you know what they say about riding a bicycle. Once you learn how to ride the bicycle, even if some time goes by and you haven't rode one in a while, all it takes is, you know, a few tries and you're right back to riding again. And I think that's the same thing with learning things. And so that's why we are going to do a repeat of all those words that we introduced back in 2021. So every month there's a new word that we introduce. And in this case, the word we're revisiting, we introduced it in January of 2021. We repeat it in 2023. And we're going to do the same for 2022. And we're going to do the same for the year 2023. And so the word that we're revisiting for this month in January is Janissary. And remember, that means to be dedicated or devoted follower or supporter of something. We hope, first and foremost, it's our Heavenly Father. But, you know, after that, something that's meaningful and has some substance. So Janissary, dedicated or devoted follower and or supporter, is our word for the month of January. All right. All right. And so remember, you can always promote your business, your service, your product, your persona, whatever it is, with Marilyn's Cafe Society. Just send your information to producer@marilynscafesociety.com, and we will certainly get all the pertinent information to you that you need. We do want to remind you of our Christmas giveaway that we start in October of every year. And so, you know, the sooner we get things in motion and planned, the better that would be. And we'd love to have you on board for that. Also, remember to check out the website, marilynscafesociety.com. That's where you can connect with me on my various social media platforms. Look for the blog link there as well. And if you want to be a special guest blogger, just reach out, all right, to marilynscafesociety@yahoo.com. And to all the YouTubers who have subscribed, thank you so much. Be sure to share with your folks, and don't go away without liking this video as well. And remember the email club, Mondays with Marilyn. To get on that email list, just send your email information to marilynscafesociety@yahoo.com. marilynscafesociety@yahoo.com, and just say, sign me up. All right. And so here's another song that I have absolutely no rights to. I don't own any rights to it, but it's sort of like a anthem song. You know how you want to, I have a couple of them, when you want to just get yourself going and motivated beyond, you know, your prayer and your praise and worship. You just want to have one of those songs that fire you up. And this is one. And listen, we survived 2021. So this song is 2022. So this song is for you as well. You ready? All right, girls, go. I'm a survivor. You're a survivor. We're all survivors. Listen, we survived COVID-19 and the pandemic, and I guess we're in an endemic. I don't know, but we're surviving it all. The inflation, the recession, the strange weather, including that recent polar vortex. Man, we're surviving it all. All of it, you know, that's been thrown at us. We've survived, everybody. So this is for you. All right, everybody. That's all I got. I just wanted to pop in. Now, listen, before we go, I want to remind you what love is. Love is morific. Love is morific. What is morific? Remember, it's working wonders. It's achieving wonderful things. It's amazing. Love is, this week, morific, all right? And remember, if you don't do anything else for this week, be sure that you live, you laugh, and you love. As always, it's a pleasure and a privilege. I'll see you next week on the show. Peace. I'm not gonna give up.